Hello everyone and welcome to the Gunpla Network. I'm The Spicer and today we'll be taking a look at the SD Sengoku Sengetsuden Machow Barbados. This review and unboxing is courtesy of Canadian Gundam, your one-stop shop in North America for all your Plamo needs. When you're over there taking a look at their catalog and placing your order, be sure to think back to this moment and use that promo code Gunpla Network for 10% off your order. The front of the box treats us to a wonderful rendition of the Machow Barbados in all of its gold and yellow and blue glory. It'd be interesting to see if we get a pretty good gold with this, because gold's really hit and miss on kits. Now on one side of the box, we do see all of the gimmicks, mostly being made up of that clear yellow plastic that almost seems to be painted gold in these images. I'm not really exactly sure, but it is molded clear yellow in the actual model kit. The other side gives us our barcode, our warnings, and the QR code for the show, which you can actually find on Gundam Info if you're here in the US, and I think possibly Canada. At least, I think North America gets it. But you can watch the show subbed for free if you're curious. This kit is based on the man, the myth, the legend, Machow, who was loved by the world of media, but not so much in real life. You see, Machow was named one of the five Tiger Generals in the Romance of the Three Kingdoms story, a high praise for both his skill in combat and his skill in command. However, outside of that world and outside of Koei Entertainment's version of him for Dynasty Warriors, Machow was largely viewed as a brutish traitor. While his real-life counterpart may not have such a shiny reputation, the AWS G08 Gundam Barbados does, and this kit seems to have a little bit of an amalgamation of all of the most popular forms, with likely the fourth form contributing the arms as they are the elongated bestial style arms that we get with the Lupus or Lupus Rex. The legs also kind of closely resemble that, but the legs don't change all that dramatically across any of the versions, so it's kind of hard to say. As far as we go outside of that with the Lupus, the shoulders are really the big tell. It's kind of hard because it could go either way. They're rounded and they've got the extra armor on the outside, so it could be the Lupus or Lupus Rex. It kind of goes either way, but I like to think it's the Lupus. And as far as the Lupus Rex goes, we've got the little tail on the very back, so a little bit of everything, which is a nice blend, and it's really cool to see it all here in front of us. And starting us off of what's in the box is the A-plate, which is molded in a gray, and the inner frame seems almost identical to every other kit I've built in this line so far. And I wouldn't be surprised if this is a PC joint plate type situation where this is kind of just the same printed for all of them. They all share the same neck and waist gimmick. As far as B goes, it's going to make pretty much all of the white up as far as the armor goes, so the headpiece, the chest, the arms, the legs, all the main armor. Then we get to the C plate, which is where we see the first fake gold, and it doesn't look terrible, honestly. Most of these kits have a pretty good, not great gold. It's passable. It could do some paint, but it's not terrible. The D plate is silver, which isn't exactly color accurate, but it's fine. It works fine for the headpiece, as it kind of has little cheeks in there. Then we've got the E-plate, which is all of our red, which is very little, but it is nice to see it's there. We also have the F1 and F2 plates, both being molded in that clear yellow, which are going to mostly make up the weapons for F1. And then the F2 plate is going to make up like the hair and the feet, which is odd that the feet are molded in clear yellow. We have the G-plate, which is going to be the side skirts, front skirts, and shoulders. So everything that realistically should have been molded blue is molded in black. We have the stickers, which there aren't very many. We've got a metallic red one for the Tekaden symbol, the eyes, and the red stickers, which are actually for the feet. We have the manual, which looks great, and the backside gives us a view of the motorcycle version. And lastly, we have the pile of plates that this kit is eventually going to transform from into this wonderful little Barbados. And all put together, this is actually quite a good looking kit, even with the flaws of the color accuracy, mostly the G plate being black instead of blue. It still looks quite nice. It gives me kind of a new Gundam style vibe with the high contrast with the black being kind of an accent color, and it overall matches fairly well with the design. Now if you were to go back and decide to paint this, there are a couple spots you would need to think about, namely the front and side skirts and shoulders. Those would need to be painted blue. The feet would need to have some red striping on them to replace those awful red stickers. And the jewel piece that covers the Tekkaden logo sticker would need to be painted, as that is portrayed as black on the box. However, if you decide not to, this is what you're getting, and it doesn't look bad. I mean, it actually looks really good in its own right with the flaws it has, and if you didn't see the series or really pay a lot of attention to the box art, you really wouldn't notice. It fits very well within its context, and even the gold isn't that distracting as far as it being maybe not the best looking. It is not necessarily going to be shiny, but it matches the rest of the suit and it kind of flows all together. The one big eye catcher here is the mace, and it isn't that it looks bad, it's just it's kind of a strange color to go with for something that's not a beam weapon. You know, the Strike Rouge's chakrams were dark blue, and that kind of made sense for a physical style weapon, but you could have easily gotten away with using the yellow on that instead of the blue, and using the blue here. I'm not sure why they went with yellow. I'm sure there's some artistic direction they went with that for some reason, but it doesn't look terrible. I'm probably going to repaint it just because I feel like the appeal of Iron-Blooded Orphans and the Barbados is how heavy and impactful a lot of those weapons are, and it's kind of a shame not to see it here, honestly. As far as head movement goes, we do get a little bit of side-to-side and back-and-forth action, but not a whole lot, as this is that typical hinge that's not going to get a lot of movement. The arms will rotate at the shoulder, pop outwards, and rotate at the bicep as well. At the waist, we'll get a little bit of back-and-forth and some ab crunch, but as it's just a ball joint, it's not a lot. As far as the front skirts go, they will go forward and back, but aren't going to go out a whole lot. They are attached to the legs, so keep that in mind. The legs do have a bend at the knee that's not a whole lot, but the feet are on a ball joint, so you do get a lot of movement out of them. As far as posability goes, you do actually get quite a bit of usable posability. The side skirts being able to move back will help make some more dynamic jumping poses look legitimate. You do have enough leg articulation, you can get some movement out of it, but just bear in mind your dynamic posing is not going to come from there. Really where it's going to shine is the torso and the arms. The arms are articulated just enough to where you can get a good grip on the mace and have some really nice swinging poses with the torso being positioned one way or the other. The head's a little tricky, but you can usually get it in enough places that's not terrible. And in terms of this kit being a Barbados, it actually looks pretty good with the high-grade lupus here. Sure, the mace is molded in yellow, so it doesn't really give you that heavy vibe, but it still feels like a Barbados, just a crazy variant of one, and that's exactly what it is. It is something that on your Iron-Blooded Orphan shelf, it will stand out, but it's not going to be an eyesore. It's going to blend well enough that even if you throw some paint on it, it's still going to match your shelf. Now, it's not the centerpiece, of course. None of these are really supposed to be. It does still work pretty well, though. And with just a little bit of love, this kit is going to look phenomenal. Whether you decide to put some paint on it or just touch it up with panel lining marker, it is going to pay off and it is going to look pretty good. Now, of course, I did decide to throw a little bit of paint at this just to see what it would look like, and it does go a long way. This does look a lot more accurate to what we see on the box art. So as far as the actual paints I used on all of the G plate, all the black parts, I used the Sky Gray Vallejo paint to base coat that, and then I painted over it with a turquoise. Pretty good looking. I think it's close enough to the color. It's not quite as rich of a blue as I'd have liked, but it's not terrible. And the gray, I just, for the mace, I just used the Sky Gray for everything. Now, it is hard to get some of those parts as there's some like internal connection pieces, but overall, I do like this a lot more. I think it fits a lot more with the aesthetic that it was going for than it did before. And overall, the use of the clear yellow on the hair fin thingy is really where it needs to be. I don't think the mace really looked great because there's a lot of surface detail that you missed with that, and the other weapons with the claws and stuff look fine, but they're really clunky and hard to pose, so I don't think I'll ever actually use them, and they don't really match the IBO vibe anyway. So the giant mace is where it's at for me, and I think with this gray or a kind of a dark gray or a light black would work pretty well with this as well. And that's it for this review. In the comments down below, let me know what you think and what is your favorite kit so far of the SD Sengoku Sengetsuden series. I've been the Spicer, this has been the Gunpla Network, and as always, keep on building.